Okay, so we've now run our full annual simulation. So I'm going to go to, this was our Run Manager dialog. Now I'm going to go to Results Viewer. And I need to find the SQL file that resulted from the simulation. So when I browse, we're in Demo 8, and the Run Manager makes a folder. So I do have to dig in there to find the actual SQL file. It'll be the only SQL file there. It'll take some time to load because it has data for the whole year. On all the surfaces, as well as the zone data that I've requested. So we'll give that some time to open. And then we'll have a checkbox for surface variables and for zone variables. And depending upon which one we highlight with the radio button, it'll change the pull-down menus. So by on surface, we just have inside and outside temperature. And on zone, it takes a little time because it's accessing the database live. We have different things we can get. For example, the sensible cooling rate or the heating rate. So let's look at the cooling rate. And when I click OK, nothing's going to happen right now. But when I switch rendering modes to render by simulation data, I then get data that I can actually drag over with the info tool and get the cooling rate in different areas. And this is time series data. So if I go over here and change the time of day or the time of year, the cooling rates will change. Now you'll notice the whole zone has the same color here. That is because I have a zone-based variable that I'm looking at now. And I can turn on shadows if you want to get a sense of where the sun is here. So the sun's hitting here and here. So this has more of a load than that does. And these are cooler back here. So what I can do now is go back to the Results Viewer dialog here and switch to surface and look at inside or outside surface temperature. And you can actually map one to the inside, one to the outside. But generally, you won't see the inside of the model unless you create a section cut or if you hide something. So now we can get surface temperatures, which you can see it changed real dynamically. Early in the morning here, the building will be cooler. The sun comes up and hits these big windows. And you'll notice the windows actually heat up first. And then the building will catch up, and the windows actually cool quicker as well. So you get some sense of the mass of the materials based on that. Here we are again looking at specific surface temperatures. So that's what you can do in SketchUp. What I'm going to do now is go back here, and actually we can launch ResultsViewer, which is a separate application, and it'll load our model into the file. So we have all of these variables here for different buildings. So these are all the surface temperatures for specific surfaces. So this is a surface. I don't know which one it is, but I can look at this as a line plot. And it shows the whole year temperature. And if I can zoom in here to look at specific times of day and times of year, and you can see how the temperature fluctuates from day to night. So sometimes that's what you want to see. And you can actually take multiple surfaces and then do line plots on top of each other. It'll take a little time. So you can compare one surface to another and see that some have more fluctuation. So I'm going to close these, though. Another thing I like to do is to do what's called a flood map. So I'm going to look at a window surface here now and do a flood plot instead of a line plot. So a flood plot shows you the whole year, and it does it in a way that doesn't require you to zoom in and out. You have hours of the day on this axis and days of the year on this axis, and you can tell what you'd expect. In the middle of the day in summer is when your window temperature is the hottest, and then winter time, early morning, late night is when it's cooler. Even in the middle of the day in winter, you still have some heat that's showing up. So it's a nice way to look at things, and you can actually, there'll be other tutorials in more detail on Results Viewer that let you see how to combine heat maps. And we can also look at our cooling rates zone by zone. So this is the west zone that I had renamed. So we can look at that as a line plot or a flood plot. And again, as you'd expect, there's some cooling happening in the hottest time, and then closer to zero other times. So if we looked at heating, we should see a much different picture. So obviously your heating is kind of reversed. So that's how that works. It's just a little intro to it, but there's a lot more you can do if you want to dig into that. And these can be printed and exported as images. So hopefully you find that useful. And next I'm going to do a video that kind of explains file management, which has changed a bit in the new version of the SketchUp plugin.